Welcome back to the deadliest catch.
Oh my God!
Did you break it? Go in, go in, do it manually, do it manually. All right,
Hello everyone, Netflix Anime Club is about to begin. I'm back again, I'm Gigguk, and joining me today is Connor, CDawgVA.
Wow. I'm so used to you introducing.
Never done it before
in my
life.
It's like being in a real Gigguk video. I'm doing well, Gon.
I didn't ask how you were doing yet.
Did you not?
No.
I
like how you just assumed that I did.
I thought you did. Oh my God.
I telepathically asked you.
Well, I jumped ahead of you.
How are you doing, Connor?
I don't want to know. I don't want to answer that question. I've already answered you. How are you doing, Connor?
Thank you, Connor. I am doing fantastically. Thank you, Connor. I'm doing fantastically.
This is the messiest start to anything ever. Oh my goodness. But Connor, right here we have these beautiful fishing rods.
Yes, these look like some Daiso fishing rods, right? if you don't know what Daiso is, it's like the Japanese dollar store, right?
Yeah. I mean, you know, you're not going to be catching real fish with these. I mean, maybe you could if you really tried.
Not exactly what they use on, like Deadliest Catch or whatever.
Right? Yeah, exactly.
go to like the Arctic.
The Megalodon has been caught with one of these. But this is because today we're going to be doing the Natsu Matsuri, which is the summer festival in Japanese. Yeah. And that's basically just where, in Japan, they have a ton of festivals where there's a ton of stalls and people pray for the harvest, they pray for good health with their family, pray for anything and just have a great time. I think it's just a good excuse to have a good time and eat lot of good food. Normally, when I've gone to them, I just eat all the food.
Have you been to one?
Yeah.
When?
Last year. You didn't go to any?
No.
Why not? There was loads of food.
I can't remember why I didn't go to any last year.
They're pretty good. You get good ice cream, you can get fresh meat. It's so good.
Yeah, I mean, my only experience with summer festivals has just been through
anime.
Yeah, the festival episode, right? That happens in every high school anime, right?
Yeah, and that's where they confess their love when the fireworks start. There's always fireworks at the end.
Yeah, you always have it's always the dating episode where they go on a date, they do the fishing activity, then they do like the shooting activity, and then one of them confesses and then the fireworks interrupts them and nothing happens.
It's very corny.
Yeah, everyone has a great time.
All right, what are we doing there? Are we fishing?
I guess so. We are fishing. And we're just going to take turns fishing, and whoever gets the most points wins, I guess. So on set, due to safety reasons, we can't have actual fish or real water. So we've just got some magnetic fish that we're going to fish.
All right, welcome back to the Deadliest Catch featuring me and Gant. We're going to be catching some points today and see who gets the most points,
exactly.
Right?
This is a good use of the inflatable hot tub.
Yeah.
Take note, Twitch. Take note.
This really is a child. Like, I don't think I could fit in this. I want to try.
It's like a kiddie pool.
Right,
we'll try that afterwards.
Go ahead.
All right, you want me to go first?
Gentleman first.
All right. Let's see. This is going to take a while. Wait. How far does this go? Okay, this doesn't go very far at all.
No. Just pick one.
I'll just pick one.
There you go.
There we go. Look at this.
That's a cute one.
This is like real life fishing.
What did you get?
I got no points. points. Oh, do you want to go, Connor?
Yeah. All right, okay. I'm going to get the watermelon. Let's get the watermelon.
It's a very cute fish here. Very cute fish.
All right, I got 10 points.
Oh my God.
Yes.
That is bull. Okay, let me try again. Okay, I'm going to go for the tomato.
Yeah, maybe the vegetable's OP.
Yeah.
All right. Aiming there.
Let's see.
Did you get a zero?
I got another 0 points.
Fantastic. I like this game. My turn. I'm going to go and get the melon. And the melon has 100 points.
What?
This is free real estate. This is fantastic. I like this game.
I'm getting my ass kicked.
Look at that. What
here.
A beautiful 100 points. I have 110 points. How many points do you have, Gone?
I have 0 currently.
And you've ruined your.
I think my thing.
Did you break it?
Go in,
do it manually.
All
do
right,
it manually.
Right, there we go. Oh my God! This isn't scripted, by the way. I apparently just suck at fishing.
All right, I'm gonna go for this one.
All right.
And the tackle is.
It is.
Oh my God, it's only got another 10 points. It's only got another 10.
All right, I'm gonna go for the small one. Maybe the small
120
one.
Points.
Okay, and we got here.
Oh, what is that?
Ah. We've got a game here.
Oh, okay.
It says game gensaku anime matomete mita. Did I pronounce that right?
Yeah, I have no idea what that means.
So apparently, there's going to be a list of anime based on video games that are currently airing on Netflix right now. And if there are any anime from the list, then we're just going to talk about it and talk about what we're interested in.
Fantastic. I'm excited for it.
Yeah. So before we get on to the anime list of video games, you just kind of smashed me in the fishing game. How many points did you get, Connor?
120 gone.
I got zero.
I like how I win when there's no punishment game. There's no punishment game today, but I won. So I guess I'll take the wins.
Pride. Well, I guess we've got to take this up to the next level and go actual fishing soon and see if you're as good catching real fish.
I'm going to break the rod in 10 seconds.
I like how I was the one who broke the rod this time.
Yeah. True.
Yeah.
So as this topic is matomete mita, like you said, Garn, we're going to be talking about video games that are also anime.
Yeah, brilliant.
And there is a bunch.
Shall we start with the Netflix original anime?
Yes, let's do it. Nice plug,
I mean, there's one obvious one, right?
Yeah,
Castlevania, right?
Of course. I
feel like Castlevania is what started the whole Netflix original anime trend.
Video games, yeah, right? Yeah, exactly. Well, there's been so many shows, but yeah, Castlevania is definitely a standout. I unironically just absolutely adore that show. I think all the voice acting is amazing. All the characters are perfect. Everything about that show I loved. And now that season 4 is wrapped up, I'm so sad because I don't know if we're getting season 5, but season 4 was so good.
Have not seen season 4. I've seen like halfway up to season 3, but I think it's amazing so far.
It's so good.
I feel like not many people are talking about it because it's like it was produced in America, but I think even so, there's like so much that Castlevania does that you don't see in typical anime.
100%.
Especially stuff with the voice acting as well. It's just, the dialogue in that is just so good.
It's so well written. Yeah. And the fact that Alucard is probably one of the hottest anime characters we've had in decades.
Are you an Alucard guy?
Dude, 100%. Like, his voice acting is like
Trevor? Not Trevor?
No, I love Trevor. I love Trevor, but Alucard like whispers all his lines. Like, yes, I am sexy. And it's like, oh, whisper louder.
Trevor is just a bro, right?
Trevor
is just a bro.
You want to drink with Trevor.
I want to take Trevor to the pub, you know?
Yeah. You want Trevor to hang out with. You want Alucard to, like, pin you down. You know what I mean? But there's also some other ones I didn't know about. Dota has an anime adaptation.
I did not know that about that either.
Didn't know this until we started shooting. Apparently, it's really highly rated. I didn't know that.
I didn't know how I'd never heard about this before because, I mean, to be fair, I'm a League guy, so I've never played Dota before.
I'm sad too.
Yeah. I too like depression.
But yeah, no, I didn't know. Why is no one talking about it, do you think?
I don't know. How many Dota players do you know?
None.
That's probably why we've not heard about
that's
it,
maybe,
right?
That's maybe why. That's
because I know one Dota player and I haven't seen him in a year because he lives in America.
That makes sense.
Otherwise, he'd probably be raving about it because I feel like you're either a League player or a Dota player. Unfortunately, we are League players.
We are the bottom of the barrel. We are the worst people on Earth.
But you know what? Maybe this is the thing that would get us into Dota, get us to convert our religion.
I've already made one mistake, Garn. I can't go replaying it more MMO. What other anime adaptations of video games are there?
I don't know. I can't remember much.
Pokemon.
Oh, how could we forget?
I just forgot about Pokemon.
How could we forget about literally one of the biggest...
The one that made it a thing.
One of the biggest anime franchises of all time. Pokemon.
And Digimon and all of those in between, right?
Yeah,
was Digimon a game first or an anime? It was, right?
I don't know. Because I think Pokemon's the only one that was a game first. Maybe Digimon was a game. Because I grew up with the assumption that Digimon was like copying Pokemon, but maybe I'm completely wrong. I don't know my Digimon lore.
Do you still watch Pokemon anime at all?
I do not.
No, me neither.
Right now, at the time of airing, the Resident Evil anime should also be out. Well, we say Resident Evil, but here in Japan, it is called Biohazard.
Infinite Darkness.
Now, I do not know much about Resident Evil.
I didn't before, but recently I just played the new Resident Evil game. It was really fun. I've started playing Resident Evil 6.
Did you enjoy the new Resident Evil game?
Yeah, it was really good. And I've heard that the movies and the anime are all kind of like a corny kind of fun.
Is it because there's a MILF in there? Is that it?
There is a MILF in there, Garn. Right, okay. You don't have to expose me in 4K like that. But yes, I liked that character. She was great. She was a lot of fun. I really enjoy the Resident Evil games, and I'm really excited to watch the anime and see how it translates into anime format. Because I feel like the Resident Evil series is at its best when it really is in like the kind of slow horror and really kind of enjoys kind of torturing you with silence for like 10 minutes and then scares you. So I wonder if the anime will capture that in some way.
Yeah, because I remember I've only watched some of the Resident Evil live action films.
They're so funny.
They're entertaining, but not because they're scary. They're just very, very corny, and especially some of the older games as well.
Yeah.
Have you seen some of the older clips of like Resident Evil 1 and
stuff? Yeah, it's so good. Oh yeah, don't go to that door.
Yeah, stop. I love that. Don't open that door.
I love those lines. Because I just sit there and I wonder, what was the direction here? What were they telling him? Like, there's no direction that explains this. I don't understand, but it was just so good. I love everything about the series. It's had its ups and downs, and I feel like the anime can go in any direction, and I am quite excited to see which one it chooses to go, whether it be corny, really suspenseful horror, or just action piece like Resident Evil 6.
It could be all of them, because Resident Evil has done all of that.
Yeah.
And it should be out right now. We haven't seen it yet, because it's not out at the time of filming, but you guys can watch it right now on Netflix.
You can spam us on Twitter and tell us to go and watch it. What are our thoughts? Who knows? Well, Gon, it has been an absolute pleasure coming to the Anime Club with you again.
Thank you very much. It's been an honor to talk about anime video games.
We've been fishing.
With a true gamer like yourself.
I am a gamer. Thank you. I am a gamer. Hopefully next time we get to game in the Netflix Anime Club.
And hopefully next time I'll get a single point when it comes to fishing.
I hope I win next time and don't have to do an embarrassing punishment game. But thank you so much for having us, Netflix. We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.